Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. Just, you know what we do. Amen. They know what's happening. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. And so, in that, in presenting your body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is a reasonable service, God also tells us not to be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by what? The renewing of your mind. Why? Why must our mind be renewed? That you might prove what is that good and perfect and acceptable will of God.
Yes.
Your mind must be renewed in order to prove the will of God. Who do we have to prove the will of God to? Those that are in darkness. Those that are around us. Because the law on the inside of us is invisible. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's hidden within our heart. It's invisible. So we have to prove that law and make it visible so people will know that there's been a change in our life.
Amen.
The only way they're going to know there's been change is that you changed what you did before to something new now. Y'all got to catch that. Amen. So if you used to drink, they'll know that you don't drink no more because you're done drinking.
Yes.
You're done going out to parties. You're done going out to nightclubs. You're done slipping wine at night before you go. Y'all got to help me. Amen.
Yes.
Praise God. There has to be a character change. Amen. Praise God. On the inside that signifies, amen, a change on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
That's how people will know. And God wants you to prove that His will is good. So in order to prove that His will is good, you got to put His will to the test. Oh, hallelujah. And when you put His will to the test, you're going to find out that God has all power over every situation. That you're going to be serving a God that never fails. You're going to serve a God that will see you when you're sick. A serve a God that will pull you out and pick you up when you're down. You're serve a God, amen, that's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you can. Oh, y'all got to catch that. Amen, that you can ask or think. And as you continue to prove the will of God in your life, there's going to build up faith in you. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the more faith that you have, the more God's resources can get to you. Because as you increase in faith, you're going to increase your capacity to receive and to believe that God can do what He said. Oh, y'all got to help me. Oh, hallelujah. And through the increase of this faith, you're going to be able to experience the power of God on a more deeper, more sincere, and a more intimate level. Amen. And this is what we want. We want to experience God on a deeper level. We're kind of, at least I am, I don't know about you, but I'm kind of done with the fanfare, the commercialism.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? I'm done with who got what on, who did this bad yesterday, and all this jargon.
Yes.
I'm done with trying to push your opinions on somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I'm done with the cliche of church.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I'm even done with trying to get dressed to come to church. Amen. Hallelujah. I don't even want to think about trying to what to put on when I come. Whatever it is, whatever available and clean and iron, put it on. Whatever you can grab and come, because God has the ability to give you what your heart desires.
Amen.
Oh, and if you desire to look clean, my God will give you something to look clean in.
Right.
Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. Because I've got a God of abundance. Y'all got to help me. Amen.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
God does not delight, the Bible says, He does not delight in the poverty of His people.
Yes.
The Bible says that He delights in the prosperity of His people. That's word. And prosperity means, there's a whole nother dynamic when we start dealing with prosperity. You when you're prospering in your health.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Amen. Praise God. God wants you to be well. That's why He told your children of Israel, when you cross over, if you stick with me, I'm not going to put none of these diseases on you that I put on them. Amen. I will heal you from all your infirmities as you come out of Egypt. I will heal you from all your infirmities, all your pain, all your trials, all the hard that hard taskmaster put you under, all that oppression, all that possession, amen, that He had you under. He will pull you out from all under that. Amen. Praise God. He won't put it on you. Matter of fact, He'll make the devil pay. Oh, y'all got to catch it. Oh, man. He'll make him pay for every affliction he puts you through. Woo! Hallelujah. That's why Israel came out with great substance.
Mm-hmm.
I just believe that some of us need to go get our stuff back.
Amen. Claim it.
I think we need to just go back and get our stuff, because the devil ain't going to tell you got unclaimed goods.
No.
He ain't going to tell you that, I got some stuff for yours. You need to be like David. Encourage yourself, even in the midst of people trying to stone you.
Yes.
Y'all got to hear that. Even if in the midst of losing your family.
Mm-hmm.
losing loved ones. Y'all gotta catch that. That's real stuff.
Yeah.
Losing to the street, to gangs, promiscuity, peer pressure, amen. And instead of weeping and moaning and complaining and murmuring about what you don't have, gird yourself up. Strengthen yourself in the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Put on the whole armor and go to battle. And go back to the enemy's camp and start proclaiming that this is mine. Take your stuff. Look at it and say, take your stuff. Just take your stuff back. Take your stuff back. Take it back. Take your stuff. Take it back. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You got to do it with an attitude. You can't be going in there. Amen. Just say, hey, devil, I'm coming. Listen to me, please. Can you please give me my stuff, please? You know, pretty, pretty. Forget that. The kingdom of God suffers what? Violence. And the violence take it by force. Hallelujah. Amen. We ain't no negotiation. This don't belong to him. My joy don't belong to you. My peace don't belong to you. My understanding don't belong to you. My knowledge, my family, my kids, my job, my finances.